theorem.
Okay. Now this leads me to talk about another very related area of mathematics, which is the complexity theory. So complexity theory is a theory that was raised by Kurt Gödel in the 1940s, 50s. Kurt Gödel, he knew that the Turing machine couldn't solve the problem of finding proofs of theorem, but he also noticed that we could only focus on short proofs, and if we only focus on short proofs, by short proofs I mean proofs that would fit in one page, for instance. If you write a one-page proof, well, you would only be using, especially if you use formal logics. In formal logics, there's only a finite number of symbols. And in one page, there's only a finite number of symbols you can fit in. So there's only a finite number of one-page proofs. Which means that if you have to prove a theorem, you can, and you're searching, and you only focus on one-page proofs, you can search them all, because there's a finite number of them, and have it done by a Turing machine. So Turing gave a systematic method to find proofs through theorems. He showed that Turing machines can find short proofs. And you can actually apply this method. Now you might be saying, okay, one page is probably not enough to prove today's theorems. But I said one page arbitrarily. You can consider all the 500 page proofs and just try them all. And this is a systematic way, which is actually powerful to solve the problem of finding proofs through theorems. So are mathematicians out of a job? Can we replace mathematicians by these Turing machines? What's the problem here? Why don't we do that?
Time.
Yeah, it's a matter of time. The problem is that the number of one-page proofs is astronomical. No way. It's not astronomical. We talked in my previous talk, we talked about big numbers. Astronomical figures are very small compared to the number of one-page proofs. There are many more one-page proofs than the number of particles in the universe. And this led mathematicians to draw a new line between what's interesting in terms of Turing machines and what's not. It's the line of complexity theory. We're only interested in the methods that are that can run in a reasonable amount of time. In particular, this led mathematicians to define what's probably one of the most important problems today in mathematics. It's still an open problem. Is the problem P versus NP. So on one hand, P here, we have the problems which can be solved in a reasonable amount of time. Okay, so those are the problems we can solve, we can actually solve. So those are the problems we are interested in and want to characterize these problems. Now, on the other hand here, NP is this set of, are the problems that which are like finding, searching for a needle in a huge haystack, except that the haystack is bigger than the size of our universe. So that's the kind of problem. Meaning probably much, 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 much bigger than our universe. And somehow it seems kind of obvious that searching for a needle in such a huge, huge haystack is unfeasible in a reasonable amount of time. But we haven't proven it yet. We don't really know if these problems are indeed unfeasible in a reasonable amount of time. And that's the core of the P versus NP problem. It's a very crucial problem. It's a $1 million worth problem. It's one of the 7 minimum price problems. It's also a crucial problem for practical reasons. Today's banking security systems are based on the assumption that some problems are very difficult to solve. Namely, they're based on the cryptography method that's called RSA, which strongly assumes that if I give you a huge number that is the product of two prime numbers, then the problem of finding out these two prime numbers, if you only know the huge number, we assume that this is difficult, that this is not feasible in a reasonable amount of time. We assume that, but we have no idea. We really don't know. And to show you the extent to which we don't know, here's a result that's proven by Agrawal, Kayal, and Saxena. they prove that the problem of testing if a number is prime or not, a huge number, the problem of testing whether it's prime or not, is indeed feasible in a reasonable amount of time. It's in P. Okay, and it's a problem that's very similar to factorizing a huge number. And this one is probably is in P, is feasible in a reasonable amount of time. Now, the reason why this is very troubling is the date here. It's only proven in, it was only proven in 2002, which is very recent. And I think it really shows to which extent we really don't know much about complexity theory. I'd say that we're very much in the dark in complexity theory. And I wouldn't be surprised, actually I would be surprised if in the next decades I would be surprised if there were no surprising results to come in the next decades. I think that in complexity theory we are kind of like mathematicians were 100 years ago when they were facing the infinity.